That's the question.
Now, let's clarify something. Now, when you say this Quran, it is translation. Okay? The Arabic Quran, when you go to the Arabic one, they tell you it's based upon the Uthman. Okay? They tell you this is based upon the Uthman Mus'haf. نعم عثمان المصحف which is the Uthman manuscript okay however this English when you go to the Arabic now I want to clarify something that our religion is not based upon manuscripts because the question that we ask ourselves who wrote those manuscripts in the first place our religion is passed down to us generation by generation the Quran was passed down to us from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam his companions thousands of them memorized the Quran for their students and they passed down to us
right.
And bear in mind the Quran we do not read it out in a cave the Quran there is we pray five times a day three prayers we recite the Quran loudly if you go to any mosque in the Muslim countries if the imam make mistakes maybe the child can correct him and this is from the miracles which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Quran وَلَقَدْ يَسَّنَّ الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِنْ مُدَّكِرٍ I want to finish the point here so thank you very much Allah said we made the Quran is easy to be memorized you see so this is from the miracles of the Quran that has been more easy to be memorized now in the Muslim so from the time of Prophet Muhammad he told his companions then his companions read out to him to make sure they understand they memorize it correctly then their students now the question I will ask ourselves and everyone here now for the sake like for instance imagine now we found the manuscript yeah backdated 1000 years ago speaks there's some verse in the Quran which is not here but in the manuscript is there the question I will ask myself who wrote that manuscript was he a trustworthy person was he an honest person was he a reliable person was he a Christian or a Muslim or a Jew because Islam doesn't mean because something is backdated 1000 years I have to go believe in it okay. Do you not agree with that
no I'll tell you my reply in a minute
I'm asking you do you agree with that
I'm not saying anything you okay. Say your argument
if you don't agree with that therefore that's why the Christians you see them drowning with their manuscripts because why they go to the Codex Sinaiticus Codex Sinaiticus or they go to the other codex yeah and there's many differences and what they think because the one is earliest therefore it has to be correct that is incorrect because maybe the one is earliest is someone who was a liar who was a disciple person
is this again
no sermon just to make clear because this point has to be clear you
all
see
right, right.
And that's why you know you told me already you watch my videos
I'm listening
so my point here is the way the Quran has been passed down to us as Imam Ibn Hazm al-Zahiri Ibn Taymiyyah may Allah have mercy upon them they say generation by generations you see and this is which is what like now if I ask anyone where is Nigeria in Africa how do we know that generation by generation knows is known that Nigeria is in Africa therefore if we find a manuscript backdated 1000 years says Nigeria in China would you accept that would you accept because why the knowledge that comes through generation by generation let alone who's those generation those generation to be trustworthy truthful honest people I hope it's clear
I've listened to you with respect yeah?
Okay no problem
right, I've listened to you with respect
go on.
Right when you get the Bible
yeah
and you see a Christian you get the NIV you get the King James and you say verse not in the NIV and it's in the King James the Bible and you do that yeah,
yeah.
And we have what is the science of textual criticism right so we have thousands of manuscripts and the more manuscripts that you have, the more you're able to get to the original text. So you've got to do textual criticism with any ancient document, right? Now, I understand what you're saying about Islam and oral tradition, and that's important to you. But at the end of the day, whether you like it or not, you've got to deal with text. Now, in this Bible, and any Bible that is published, we can find out the scholars and we can find out the ancient texts that they've used. Right? And all I'm saying with you, right? I understand your argument that you're making,
yeah.
But it doesn't cut water. You've still got to deal with text, right? That's text, right?
Yeah.
So if that's a text, if someone's produced that text,
yeah.
They've got to produce the evidence. Like, have you got imams in your faith? You've got
yeah.
imams. We got priests.
We've got imams.
When
yeah.
I preach, like, I'm like an imam in your faith. Like,
okay.
If I'm preaching, we have Greek and Hebrew manuscripts, right? And we can say, I disagree with that scholar. I disagree with that scholar. And we can check. And so you've got to have text to that. You've got to have ancient text. And if you haven't, it's anti-intellectual to say, oh, we've got oral tradition, but we don't have to talk about the text.
Okay.
It's not fair. It's like getting into a boxing ring and tying my hands behind my back and smacking me all over the face, and I can't fight back because I'm saying, I've got text, but you don't have to show any text. You've got to show text. So what manuscripts is that based on?
Before we go to that, let us elaborate upon your point. Your point, you said, we have many manuscripts, correct?
Yeah.
And now, what I'm saying, logically speaking, doesn't mean because you have many manuscripts, therefore, one of them has to be correct. We question you, any logical person, any person with rationality, with intellect, will ask the question, who wrote that manuscript? Who is he? Let alone the earliest manuscript that you have is, let me be generous with you, 200 years after Jesus. You see, that's the earliest manuscript that you have. You see? So what I'm saying, the question, 200 years gap, who wrote that manuscript? Was he the trustworthy, honest person, truthful person? And now, as is the Quran, the scholars that we have, they study, their teachers, goes back to Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So Prophet Sallallahu taught the companions, like now, recently a book, which is one of our scholars, Ahmad al-Najmi, may Allah have mercy upon him, 2 volumes. He has what's called Isnad, strong weapon, you see, not a physical weapon, but spiritual weapon, yeah, evidence, which is one of the, our scholars, Ahmad al-Najmi, may Allah have mercy upon him, yeah. Him, when you come to Quran, Hadith, it has a chain of narration, which from him, it goes back to Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. How? He studied under the teacher, who studied under the teacher, and he goes back to Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. But bear in mind, that is not enough, because you have a chain of narrators that goes back to Prophet Muhammad. What we put as a Muslim is a criteria, that in every narrator in that chain, it has to be a trustworthy person, honest person, truthful person, not enough, with a strong memory. He's known to have a strong memory. So let us analyze that. Imagine I take something from him. He gives it to me, I give it to him. And then I give it to you. Then he comes, he take it from him. Then he comes, take it from him. Then it spreads. When we look at it, it's the same Quran. You see, this is God and gets a Chinese whisper, which is the Quran, because they say Chinese whisper, no. Chinese whisper, yeah, that man said, like imagine the brother tell me I was in a holiday. By the time he gets to the fifth person, he said, no, he was swimming. Yeah. Or something like that, you see what I'm saying? So this is them, the scholars of Islam, the criteria they put in order for us to accept anything that came from Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is a strong criteria. As for the manuscript, you know, everyone knows the manuscript that has been found in Birmingham, which is the same as the Quran we have now.
No.
You see?
No.
So what I'm saying, you cannot impose your criteria upon me. This is the Western criteria.
Okay.
That is not, don't bring it to me. You see, that's the problem when the Western, they try to bring their own criteria, try to impose it on us. No, I don't accept the criteria. I have to have a manuscript. No, because a manuscript is not enough for me. I want to know who wrote the manuscript. But what is enough for me if I know this man, he studied under this man, it goes back to Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Not just one chain of narration, with many.
It's not like Chinese whisper.
No way.
Can I come in?
You said it should be the other way around.
I have notes in there. I can give you PhDs of people who studied Arabic and give you arguments about that and stuff, right? About
who are they? Muslims?
Western.
Orientalists. Yes. Well,
no, not Orientalists.
That's why I mean Orientalists.
Orientalists. No, but what I'm saying is.
Okay, go on. Sorry. Why would
you call? Well, let's go back to your own sources. In Uthman.
Yeah.
When Uthman compiled the Quran.
Yeah.
Your argument is based on chain of narration and the need for oral tradition.
Yes.
But if you read Bukhari and you look at what Uthman said.
Yeah.
Uthman made a compilation of the Quran because of pronunciation, arguments of pronunciation. Okay. Would you agree? Yeah?
Yeah.
So the very,
fact
that he made a compilation because of that shows you that you just didn't need...
You're wrong in that statement.
You didn't just need oral tradition, but you needed a text.
No, you're wrong in that statement.
Let me finish here, because I've listened to you before.
Yeah, of course.
The second thing is that if you read, you quoted a mother scholar at Birmingham University or whatever about this Quran.
Yeah, this manuscript. Yeah, yeah.
If you read Cambridge Companion to the Quran, right, which a lot of Muslim scholars like to quote, yeah? If you read, I've seen debates from...
No, I'm not one of them, because I told you... I don't lie, I'm just showing you that.
Well, I've seen debates from these Muslim...
Yeah, you're speaking to me,
And they quote these scholars, yeah, but what I've noticed is a lot of them have said this, and I can give you the names if you want the names.
I don't need them, to be honest.
And they say this, the Quran in the manuscripts that we found, it's reliable. This is what they say. These are the modern academics, yeah?
Okay.
But here's what they say. We've never been able to make a Quranic text by looking at all the Quran texts that we have, the ancient Qurans. There's one in Birmingham, there's one in Turkey, there's one in Yemen. Wait a minute. There are these ancient manuscripts, yeah? And the scholars are complaining that they've never been able to bring them all together and make a text and see whether it has changed or not, right? And what I see there is biased, even in Western academia. Western academia is very scared to upset Islam because they're contradicting themselves. Wait a minute, they're contradicting themselves. They're saying on the one hand the manuscripts verify it, and on the other hand they're saying we don't know because we've not been able to make a compilation. Now, if that was happening in Western scholarship, you'd be laughed out of court. If we couldn't get all the manuscripts to compile the Bible and see how they work together, we'd be laughed out of court. That is intellectual honesty. And second thing is oral tradition. Christianity came through Judaism. Judaism has had a long oral tradition. 1 Corinthians 15 is a source that comes right early on in the time of Jesus. And it's because of oral tradition. We have oral tradition. But again, at the end of the day, when a text is written down, it gets copied. It gets copied. A text. Not just oral tradition. Wait a minute. And when texts are copied, right, there are going to be made mistakes, yeah? We have thousands and thousands of copies. And the more copies you have, right, the more you can able establish a text.
Oh, really?
You can.
Anyway, please. Let me elaborate on that.
This is Western scholarship.
Yeah, first of all, I made it clear to you that the scholars
in
the
West. Have you read anything about textual criticism?
I read.
But what have you read?
Let me finish now.
What have you read?
Before we go to that.
Tell me what you've read.
I have a book which is called Quranic Text by Ibn.
No, I'm on about Western textual criticism. Have you read any books on textual criticism?
No, not really. Not too much.
Okay.
Not too much. But now, why? I'll tell you why. First of all, I told you clearly that you don't use your criteria.
Let you have the last say.
Yeah. But remember, I have to ask you a question because you want
one question after this. I'll have your last
saying. Then I'm going to. What I'm saying, you made. Let's clarify many things here you made. One of them, that I told you already, don't bring your criteria, the Western criteria, try to impose it on me. Because I understand that the Western scholars, they don't have isnad like us, chain of narrations. That's why they're drowning in the manuscripts. But the question I'll ask you, please, be honest person.
I'll be honest, yeah?
Do you know who wrote the earliest manuscripts?
What do you mean, who wrote the earliest manuscripts?
In Christianity, the earliest manuscripts. Do you know who wrote it?
We've got, look, I can
No, read. I ask you, who wrote it? Listen, carefully, listen.
I can read the manuscripts here.
Yeah, but I didn't say who wrote it.
Don't read it, we actually who wrote it.
I can read that, I can give you the files if you want the files.
I study about it, listen. You know Bart Ehrman?
I've studied Bart Ehrman.
Yeah, okay. I study about his works and that. What I'm saying, listen carefully. Who wrote Sinaiticus, Codex Sinaiticus?
We don't know who wrote Sinaiticus.
Okay. Was it trustworthy?
90% trustworthy.
I'm going to tell him that. Why, you don't think I don't have the same brain? I'm going to tell him, if you don't know who wrote it, how are you going to know he's trustworthy?
Because you don't know what textual criticism. Wait a minute.
No, ask him this.
No,
be honest.
No, be honest. No, let me
go.
In textual criticism, right, that we have families.
You have what?
We have what is called families. There are four main families in textual criticism, right? There's the Antioch. Copies were made at Antioch. Copies were made in Europe. Yeah?
Then Egypt and I understand that. Okay.
And we have four groups of families, right? Now, if a manuscript is in one family, Sinaiticus is from the Egyptian family, yeah?
Yes, say that, yeah.
Right. Now, if you've got manuscripts that are in the four groups of families, it's a good manuscript. Sinaiticus is only in one family, so it's not a very reliable source. But if you get a manuscript that's in the four families, that comes from Egypt, from Europe, from Turkey, from four different areas of the family, then it's a good source. Yeah?
Okay.
So what I'm saying is that if you know about these families and how textual criticism works, then you understand, you'll be able to engage in it.
No, but to be honest, you have asked my question. What I'm saying, I have two Bibles in my suitcase.
Yeah.
I have King James Bible, New World Translation, you see. The King James Christian said, no, this is the word. We don't accept anything except this one. The newer translation said, no, the King James one, there's many stuff in there which is not in the earliest manuscript.
You're making a straw man argument.
Huh?
It's a strong
when you say, so I'm saying, listen carefully, which I have it now. Like, what I can do, you can. Sorry, yeah.
You said New World Translation.
Yeah, that's what I have. Let me show you.
Come back when you finish.
Let me show you something here.
Are you going to keep this as it is?
Of course, he's not going to.
He won't edit it, yeah?
No, he's a trustworthy brother. We just here to. Okay. This is the Bible, yeah? That's the Bible, yeah? You have.
What's that one? ESV.
Okay, ESV, King James. There is verses here, it's not in here. And vice versa, yeah? So this
get
one.
Get another Quran when you're doing that.
Yeah, I have a Quran. Get another Quran. We have a Quran.
Get another Quran, yeah?
Yeah, get another Quran.
No, I'll show you something. I'll show you something.
Yeah. In Arabic, yeah? In English. Right? Anyway,
but
I haven't finished. So my point here is that you don't know the person who wrote the earliest manuscript. So you said, yeah, 90% trustworthy. You cannot really say that because why? If you don't know the person, Aslan, originally, how are you going to visit trustworthy or not?
Because you need to know textual criticism.
I know, listen, I studied about Ehrman's works and everything.
Ehrman. Have you ever read Bruce Metzen?
No, I haven't read it. Okay. Okay. What I'm saying, my point here is, look, what I'm saying, yeah? And now, let us make it clear that's why the Christian, you see them drowning and they're not even sure, let alone the earliest manuscript is a copy of a copy of a copy of, let alone you don't know who's Mark. You don't know who's
I'm not moving.
I'm talking about the Bible. Remember?
Wait. Stated textual criticism.
Yes, what I'm talking.
Text. Yeah. No, you're moving
the
about,
Bible.
You're moving about looking at the original.
Because you know what? I'm going to go to the foundation.
No. If you want to go to that, we'll go to that.
Yeah? Go to the foundation.
I'll get the notes. No,
okay.
Notes
go to the foundation.
I want to know about the
wait,
text.
Wait. I'm going to show you before that. If we go to John, you said John wrote the Bible, yeah? But we can see John never wrote the Bible. How can we know that? We go to the end of John and listen to what he said. Matthew or John, we're going to check it, yeah? You're going to read that you can see John never wrote this gospel. Okay, because you did it with the criticism, yeah?
Right, when you've done this,
listen to this, yeah? This is John, the one who's supposed to write it, yeah? Listen, this is the disciple who testify of these things and wrote these things, and we know that his testimony is true.
Yeah.
So the question, who wrote this? If you're saying the one who said this testimony, because he's speaking about the third person, it's his. So he's saying the one who's writing this. No. These are textual critics.
Did you follow that?
Listen carefully, yeah? He says here, yeah, this is the disciple who testify of these things and wrote these things. If you shout, wallahi, that man leave him. That's why, inshallah, I'm coming. This is the first time I met him. So, inshallah, he's sincere and we are sincere seeking the truth. Yeah? So, listen to this, yeah? So, this is the writer, the one who's writing this, he's saying this, yeah? This is the disciple who testify of these things and wrote these things, and we know that his testimony is true.
Right.
Who is he?
It's John.
John talking about himself?
Yes.
John.
Okay. What is known, that time they never used to use this term as a third person.
Wait a minute. You're going on. You've moved from textual criticism. Let me come in.
Let me come in. John, I think you missed the point. That's a textual criticism. I'm going to the heart.
Let me just read the text.
Read it.
Let me read the text.
And prove to me that it's John speaking.
It says, then these sayings went out among the brethren, that the disciples would not die, and Jesus did not say to him, right? And then he says, this is the disciple.
And we know that his testimony is true. What's wrong with that?
Who's this person?
We know.
No.
This is the disciple.
Step by step.
Do you know why? Let me explain.
You said it's John. Prove to me it's John. Prove to me that John's speaking.
I can prove to you, John, because if you read the book, yeah, it talks about the beloved disciple in the Gospel of John. And we know, wait a minute, we know the beloved disciple was John. That was the special name to John.
No.
And it says that in the Gospel of John. Wait a minute, let me finish, yeah?
Okay.
We also have multiple attestation. We have Irenaeus who mentioned that it's of John, and we have other ancient sources that mention John near the time. So we have internal text and outside text. We also have evidence that it's eyewitness. Have you ever read the Gnostic Gospels?
I haven't already.
Right.
But just focus on this point.
If you read the Gnostic Gospels, all the Gnostic Gospels and compare it to the Gospel of John. Gospel of John mentions loads of times historical things in Jerusalem at the time of Jesus, like the Pool of Bethesda and the five porches, yeah? And if you read the Gnostic Gospels, they don't say anything about the historical times of Jesus.
Wait a minute.
So we know that this is based on eyewitnesses. Now you've moved. You're a clever guy.
No, I haven't moved.
You're a clever guy. You've moved from textual criticism to this. I want to...
That's textual criticism, isn't it?
No.
I'm going to the heart.
Be honest now. I asked you a question, right? Yeah. I said, what is the ancient manuscript behind the Quran, right? Yeah. Right? Now, when you come here and you say, there's no verses in there, we're intellectually honest in the West. I can say, we know the ancient manuscripts of that. We know the scholars that made that. We know the ancient manuscripts of that. We know the scholars. But you admitted yourself, you admitted to me that you don't know the manuscripts in the Quran.
I didn't say that.
Yes, you did.
No, you said. I said, I don't base my belief upon the manuscripts.
You said this. You made it clear. You said this. This is what you admitted. You said to me that we have oral tradition. Did you not?
Also, carry on.
You said oral tradition.
Also?
Right? Then you said to me that your Quran was based in a text in Turkey, right?
Manuscript of who?
Yeah, Uthman.
Uthman. So I said there's manuscripts.
Then I called you out and I asked for the Arabic or read it out in your Quran. You never read it.
Excuse me, I said there's no Arabic here. I'm going to read something not there.
Read it out now.
That's translation.
Right? Read it out now. So I can't see you.
No, be honest. So now you said to me to read it. How can that be a translation?
Right here, let's go back again. We know the manuscripts here, we know the manuscript. What manuscripts behind that Quran?
Okay, now you're telling me. I told you it's Uthman.
Right, okay. Where's the text?
Go to the Arabic one.
Where's the text?
Do you understand that? He's in the Arabic one. When you go to Arabic one, right. You go to the end, right. He mentioned... allow me to speak now.
Let me just finish.
No, but how are you going to finish? You can't...
Because you went on the Gospel of John and...
Yeah, but you asked me a question. Let me finish.
Just finish this and then I'll let you speak.
Okay, go on.
We have a manuscript in Rylands University, at Rylands Library. We have an ancient Gospel of John, yeah?
Yeah.
Right? These Gospels are based on that, right? That's just a little bit, right?
How is it be based upon if John is the 520 over?
Right?
Come on, let me finish. Go on.
We have Sinaiticus, Vatican, we have many
other...
We have the Byzantine text,
okay.
Right, which is 5,000 texts, yeah?
Okay.
The Sinaiticus comes from a small group of texts, yeah?
Okay.
Only a handful.
Okay.
And we have 5,000, right? And we know what texts these are based. We know what universities they're based in, and we know what scholars have used them, right? So here's the question. We have manuscripts in Yemen of the Quran. We have manuscripts in Birmingham. We have manuscripts in London. If you read the Cambridge Companion to the Quran, all the scholars admit, every scholar
Muslim
admits,
scholars?
All the, no, there's non-Western scholars as well.
No.
The scholars admit that we've never made a Quran based on all these ancient Quran manuscripts.
So what do you want me to do? You want me to accept...
No, so you're intellectually dishonest.
No, it's not.
No, you are.
You're speaking, let me speak. First of all, how can I trust the people who came to my country, invade my people, colonize me for many years, and now when they came to know that we cannot force Muslims to become a Christian, they came to us from a different door that we are here to help you. So we're going to study your manuscripts and we'll tell you which one. Please, I'm speaking. Wallahi. We're going to come to tell you what is the Orientalist. Orientalists, those scholars from the West, Western scholars who study about the Islamic world. More general, they study about the Eastern world. That's why they call the Orientalist. Yeah? What I'm saying, logically speaking, how can I trust a man who is known for his hidden agenda, for his bias, to try to destroy Islam? Because there's many Orientalists who said clearly, like the French one, who said to them, the French, when they came to Algeria, there is no point try to force the Muslim to become a Christian. What you do, destroy the Quran, then you see the Muslim destroyed. So how can you tell me, I don't care about Cambridge, I have own scholars. I was in the Quran, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Ask people of knowledge, you didn't say ask the Cambridge. So listen, I'll let you speak. Now you went off a subject clearly. What I'm saying clearly, that logically speaking, we have how many Quran we have? One Quran. How many Bible do you have?
Listen carefully now.
If a person comes to you, a layman, listen carefully to me now. If a layman comes to you, who doesn't have the ability to go to London Museum, British Library. If a Christian comes to me, easily I pick up two Bible and I show him there's two Bible.
Listen carefully to me.
The Catholic, how many is the Catholic? No, I'm not switching. I'm showing you that you have many Bible.
Stick to the argument.
If you allow me to finish, if you allow me to finish, how many? What is the question?
Stick to the argument.
That's what I'm doing. That's what I'm doing.
Stick to the argument.
Khalas, I have to leave. Seriously, because there's no sincerity now. We're just debating. No, no, I'm not saying about you. Maybe me. But what I'm saying.
I'm asking.
I'm speaking.
Let me ask.
Allow me to finish my points. Okay. What I'm saying to you, allow you speak as well. But what I'm saying, my point here is that if we're gonna debate for the sake of debating, I'm saying logically speaking, we just ask how many Bible about the manuscripts. I'm telling you, we have one Quran. You have many Bible.
You have the Quran. You
haven't
proved it.
Do you know any? I can prove it.
You can't prove it.
Okay. Any Muslim get the Quran from your iPhone?
Yeah, because you haven't got the text. You haven't proved.
You've got the text.
No, listen. Let me finish.
Who are you talking about the text? The Quran will pass down to us, generation by generation. No manuscript. Don't use the Western upon us. That's why I'm clarifying to you.
Right.
You understand my point?
My brother here says Western scholarship.
Yeah.
These scholars, these Islamic apologists here, Paul Williams and others, quote the Cambridge Companion to the Quran in their debates. They love to use the Cambridge Companion. So the scholars in there that are not Western scholars, some are Eastern scholars, yeah?
Is my name Paul? No,
but you're making an argument about colonialism. Let me finish. In the Cambridge Companion to the Quran, I'd encourage you to read it. It's pro-Islam. There's a lot of stuff saying, confirming the Quran, yeah? But they're all honest and saying, listen, they're all honest. We have never made a Quran yet based on all the ancient Quranic manuscripts. Listen. It's no good saying there's changes in the Bible. You have to provide a text. And it's no good going on about Uthman and about oral tradition, because Uthman even had to have a text. You've got to give us the text, and you haven't done it.
Have you read the text in Turkey? Let us go for the sake of argument.
I don't know Arabic.
The text is the same
question.
Same Quran.
I see.
Backdated, the Uthman's time, the first century. Don't tell me we. I'm not. Listen carefully. Can I speak now? Here, you can take
show
your view
me.
If you want.
Jason, be honest.
I told you this is a translation. In the Arabic Quran, it mentions how this Quran is based upon. Yeah, let me touch my point, please. Translation is based upon the Arabic Quran.
What's the one that you use? The translation of the Quran that you use. What's the name?
Depends on the people who are translating.
What's the Quran that you use?
It's the King Said one. Let me finish my point. No, you can ask me a question, then jump in. Listen. I'm saying to you, don't tell me my religion is not based upon the Western scholars. So I'm saying you keep going to this.
He's talking about the translation. He's telling you the translation comes from the Arabic, the original.
No. Yeah, that's it, yeah.
Come from anywhere.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So my point here is, we're not waiting for... The original Quran, look, Quran, clearly. What you're doing, if you not notice, you're trying to impose the criteria.
I'm going to show you that you're doing that.
Listen carefully.
No.
I was speaking.
I'm asking, that's not an honest intellectual question.
Yeah, can I answer it?
You cannot say the Bible's changed. We have text.
We have two Bible.
No, we have text.
Yeah.
Listen, we have ancient text. We compare it. We know where they're done, yeah?
Yeah.
Right? I'm asking a
simple,
I'm asking a simple question.
Yes.
Right? What Quran do you use? Or what are the ancient manuscripts? Have they gone to Turkey and used that one?
Yeah.
Have they used the Birmingham one?
No, the Birmingham is two pages.
All the scholars in the Cambridge Companion to the
again Bible. Western scholars.
No,
you're not getting the points.
Western.
I'm not. There's no scholars. Listen. There's no scholars in the West.
Let me be clear to you, please.
There is no Islamic scholars. Listen. There is no Islamic scholars in the West. Get this point right. There is no Islamic scholars in the West.
So they're all biased.
No, I'm not going
to
say that. Listen carefully to me. I'm going to explain to you. The scholars in Islam, when you say is a scholar in Islam, means that he studied under a scholar, who studied under a scholar, and he goes back to Prophet Muhammad. if someone who just came from nowhere, he studied Arabic in Cambridge University, and he studied religion, Islamic religion in Oxford University.
They're not from.
No, listen carefully, I'm saying, give you an example.
They're not from.
Okay, name one of them. No, name one of them.
I can give you the name.
Okay, tell me who these scholars. If it's not Sheikh Ben Baz, if it's not Sheikh Albani, if it's not Sheikh Salah Al Fawzan, if it's not Sheikh Rabia, if it's not Sheikh Qiti, then he's not a scholar. Let's make it clear to you. That's why the beauty of Islam, look how it's been preserved. Even how to go back to the scholars. That the scholars that we go back to, who are known by the other scholars, and it goes back to who? To Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar. Our knowledge has been preserved. The Quran has been preserved. The prophetic tradition. You gotta give me the name, yeah? And tell me who's his scholars, who's teachers.
These are my notes.
Anyway,
I've got two volumes of notes.
Yeah, the notes, which is one of them you were wrong. You told me verse is not there, which.
Have you ever read the Quran? Have you ever read the Cambridge Quran? The Cambridge companion to the Quran?
I don't need that.
Have you ever read it?
I don't need it.
So you don't know what you're talking about?
No, what do you mean? I'm a Muslim. I don't go to Western scholars who is known that are Orientalists who have bias toward Islam and they have a hatred for Islam and they try to come to us. No. We are here to help you. They give you, listen. They give you, know what they do? They give you honey. They give you poison in honey. They say, you know, here honey for you, but better man is the poison there. They praise Islam, they praise the Quran. My point here is, you come to a person, I'm a Muslim Salafi. What is a Salafi? A person who for the Quran and the prophetic tradition, the way the Prophet Muhammad disciples understood it. So the way we understand the Quran, based upon Prophet Muhammad's teaching and his companions, likewise, the scholars, they study under them. Not a scholar who studied in Oxford University or Cambridge.
The scholars,
I made it clear to you.
No, the scholars are from Cambridge.
Huh?
It's called the Cambridge Companion to the Quran.
Name one of them. Name one of them.
I've got two volumes here. I've got to find my
just
own.
Name one of them.
I'm getting them.
Okay.
Them,
yeah. My point here is, look, now, alhamdulillah, that's the beauty of Islam. That the Christians, what they're doing, what the Christians doing, they try to bring their criteria. Because I'm not speaking about Jason, but what happened in the West, they still have that invaders mentality. That our way is better than anyone's way. If you don't follow our way, therefore you're wrong. So our way is you have to have a manuscript. No, we don't have to have that. Because Islam is based upon the companions. No, sir. The companions. Can I speak now?
Paper. So you don't have textual.
Okay.
Or was it written on something else?
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
The companion.
All right. Here's one. Yeah.
I'm speaking. Right. Let me finish with one.
Okay.
The companions, they pass it to the prophet, the student, then we have it. And not just any person knows. In every generation, there were scholars in Quran. Prophet Muhammad's time, the companions, their students who are hufad, memorizers of the Quran and the scholars of the Quran. So until our time. That's why our a'imma, our scholars of Quran, we go back to Prophet Muhammad. Clear. The manuscript problem, you don't know who wrote it. You could be the biggest guy in the world with the manuscript.
Sir, can I come in now? Can I
go on. Tell me the tea student.
This woman here, Muslim apologist, quote her all the time.
What's her name?
She's called Angelica Newworth.
I never accept her as a...
Have you ever read her?
No, wait. It's not about reading her. No. Jason. Let me help you. Be honest, Jason.
Do you know where she's from?
It's not about reading her.
Where she's from?
Listen carefully.
Where's she from?
Let me finish, please.
Where's she from?
I want to tell you what is the scholars in Islam.
Is she from Cambridge?
I don't know her.
She's from Germany.
Where it started? You know where this Orientalism started? In Germany.
Yeah.
That's where it started, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So you just...
No, let me finish.
Jason, I want to show you something, please. Because I have to go pray Asr.
One minute.
Yeah. Subhanallah.
She is quoted by Muslims to defend the Quran. Yeah.
Listen, I don't care what a Muslim says.
No.
I'm speaking to Shamsuddin.
No, wait.
You're not speaking to Paul.
You're not speaking to Mahmoud. You can't have your cake and eat it. These Muslim scholars quote her all the time.
They're not scholars. I'm telling you.
I'm on the Sheikh Membez. Yeah?
Which scholars?
Right.
Name my scholars.
Listen.
I ain't getting the points, subhanAllah.
Let me give you the
okay,
point.
Okay, go on.
Let me just finish. When you read the academic West, right, what you're saying is...
West.
No, listen. When you read the scholars on the Quran of the academic West, right,
yeah,
they're very, very frightened to actually criticize the Quran because there's a group of scholars called Patricia Cole and Waynesborough, and they've been very critical of the Quran, right? So they've been sidelined in the academic world at the moment. And what we have is a lot of liberal intellectuals who in the West who are frightened to actually be honest about the situation with the Quran. Now, all of these scholars...
Western scholars, he's still talking.
No, wait a minute. They actually confirm what you believe, because they're all saying, right? They're all saying this. This is the... You can read it, Cambridge Companion to the Quran. They're all saying, all the manuscripts that we have has confirmed the Quran text, right? That's what they're all saying, right? But they're all saying at the same time that they're absolutely tired and sick that nobody has been able to make a Quran based on all the manuscripts that we have in Turkey, wherever.
Is my scholar saying that?
Listen.
Now I'm asking Jason.
No,
you keep saying Western scholars.
This is important.
We're going around
what
the circle.
Means, no, what that means is, this is intellectual honesty. What that means is, when you hold your Quran there, you have absolutely no intellectual credibility to say that that text is the original text, because nobody's ever done any scholarship to get all this.
What is scholarship?
You compare the manuscript.
That is the Western scholarship?
No,
or, no, wait. Is that Western scholarship or Muslim scholarship?
You read.
Again, Western scholarship. I'm telling you, no. Listen.
Read Bukhari, a Muslim.
Okay.
They do textual criticism. Actually, the early classical scholars, Tabari and people like that, they were people who were intellectually honest, and they had variants, and they said there are these manuscripts, and that there's a variant here and variant there. They were honest.
Wait, Tabari said that?
Wait,
you made a claim against Tabari. Jason, step by step. Let me finish. We're going to finish now because I have to go pray.
The point what I'm getting is, the argument is this. You cannot say to the Christians, here's the Bible, that changed. We have text, we can show you the text. You haven't got a text, because you've never done any scholarship where you've gathered all the ancient texts from Turkey to Iman to Yemen to Birmingham. You know why? Because a lot of the scholars, Western scholars, are not allowed to go and see the manuscripts in Yemen.
They're not
allowed to go.
Recently. That's not true.
Again.
The point I'm trying to make clear to him. Listen.
It's true, isn't it, bro?
Jenson, you went off. You told me you're going to show me a scholar, which I believe is a scholar. That woman, I don't believe she's a scholar.
You've never even...
Excuse me, I'm going to show you that. Islamically, what is a alim? Who is a scholar? Ibn Abdul Barr al-Numairi, who lived 1,000 years ago. He said, not for anyone to say who is a scholar in Islam. It's for the scholars of Islam to point who is a scholar, who is not. And that goes back to the Prophet Muhammad So Prophet Muhammad directs us to take knowledge... Can I speak? Directs us to take knowledge from Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali. Then his companions direct us to take knowledge from who? From Sa'id al-Musayyib. Then the Tabi'in, which is a student of the companions, directs us to another student, and it comes back to our time.
Excuse me.
Can I speak now? I know it's boiling. But remember, enough. So my point here is, I have two Bible here.
Yeah,
you see, can I speak now? You don't know what happened to the Romans, the Christians.
Okay, listen. Scholars, one burnt the other one.
Can I speak now? It's Christians speaking.
Go on, I'm
going to be respectful.
I'm going to respect.
Okay, my point here is, he kept saying the West. Who is the West? The Orientalist. And I mentioned, what is Orientalist? Al-Mustashriqun. In Arabic, who is Orientalist? Like I can't remember his name, Goldzeh Varusan, who is known to lie against Islam clearly. He goes to who? He claimed Prophet Muhammad, he took from the Bible. He claimed many things. He is the head of and the founder of this Orientalism, which is the Western scholars study about the Islamic world. When this happened? After the invasion of the Europeans to the Muslim countries. When they came to know, they cannot force a Muslim to become Christians. There's some Muslims solid in their religion. So one of them from France, he said, let the Algerian, the best way to deceive them, go to the Quran and bring misconception about the Quran and destroy the Quran. I'm saying, logically speaking, your religion is based upon a manuscript. You don't know the name who wrote it. You don't know the trustworthy, the truthful person. And now, I know the Quran that I'm reciting. It goes back to Prophet Muhammad SAW. Why? Because I took it from a sheikh, who took it from his sheikh, I got Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Not just one line, we have over 1,000 scholars who were scholars of Quran, and they have students to see. So that's why we have one Quran, one recitation. There's many recitations of Quran, but one Quran. You see what I'm saying? So please, again, I let you speak for a long time though.
Okay.
You spoke. My point here, again, we're going to go around the circle. Listen carefully. Don't bring your criteria to impose it on me. So don't tell me in the West we have not read the manuscripts. We are not in need of that. Because our Quran is not just we go to a cave, look for a manuscript, and say, yeah, I'm going to believe in it. No, we don't believe that. Maybe the biggest crackhead in the world wrote that manuscript. I don't have to base it, but when you know who wrote, like now, I'll give you an example. Everyone, who is Nigeria? I'm asking, who is Nigeria? In Africa. Imagine now we found the manuscripts backdated 2,000 years. It said Nigeria is in China. Would you believe that? Why? Because the knowledge that we have about Nigeria came through generations, let alone the Quran. The Quran, not just generation, established facts, well known. The Quran came through, trustworthy, honest, strong in memory. Now, I have two Bible. King James and the old translation. Show me the Quran. I challenge you. Show me the Quran.
Let's test this old tradition, yeah? Let's test it, okay?
Okay.
Right, are you ready? I go to the shop, I get £5 of spuds, I get £5 of carrots, I get a packet of cigarettes, I get a bottle of whiskey, all right? I go to Paris on holiday, right? I come home, I feed my cat, I feed my dog, right? My dog is white, my cat is ginger, okay? Tell me, repeat it, word for word.
That's a proof as a miracle.
No. Let's test your oral tradition. Repeat it.
Cool little star.
No. Repeat.
Can I speak now? That's the sweetest and guess him why?
No, because
we cannot memorize it, but we can memorize the Quran. And that's what Allah said in the Quran. That Allah made it easy to be memorized. So we just get sweeted. Anyway, the point's clear. I'm just here for the sake of debating. Subhanaka wa bihamdik. No, it's finished. I can see that it's not clear. I'm telling you, look, your oral speech is not a God speech. Okay? Just can I ask you something before you go? How can you believe God died?
How can you believe God died? Okay, yeah. I'll answer the question.
Yeah, go on, please.
You want me to answer the question?
Yeah.
Can God die?
No.
Right.
But you believe God died?
No, we don't believe God.
Do you believe
God
Jesus God?
No. Wait a minute.
I'm going to show you.
No.
I'm going to show you.
No. Wait a minute. No, you let me answer now. Let me answer, because this is a very
important... But I haven't speak.
No, this is a very important question
go on.
For a Christian.
Go on.
Very, very serious. So I'm not going to...
Inshallah, you're going to do with it. Yeah? Just look.
God cannot die.
Okay.
In the Quran, it says the Quran is eternal.
The Quran says what?
It says the Quran is eternal.
Show me in the Quran what says eternal.
There's a verse in...
No. Show me here.
There is a verse.
Come back next week. No, wait.
I have.
Is there a camera? I'd say the Quran. Next week, come back. Show me what's the Quran.
Wait a minute. Excuse me. I have the verses, but I've got. Look at the notes here. You asked me for Cambridge Companion. You asked me for the names of the scholars.
Listen.
And I took my time and I thought it.
The question about God now. The Quran.
I have the verses. But I haven't got the time.
No. I don't want to tell you. Please.
Excuse me, but I have files there, right? I can bring them, yeah? There's the point.
Excuse me, what about God?
Let me finish.
You go on.
Right?
Just show the verse.
God cannot die.
Okay.
Right? When Jesus Christ was on that cross, it was the body that died. God cannot die.
Right? Okay.
Wait a minute, right? You burnt the Quran. Uthman burnt the Quran.
Yeah.
Did that destroy God's word?
No.
Right.
Okay.
So if it doesn't destroy God's word, yeah, Jesus' body dies, it doesn't destroy God.
Okay, that's it. So are you saying, can you show us in the Bible where Jesus said, my body is not God, but my spirit is God?
Yeah.
Show me.
My body is not God.
Show me in the Bible that Jesus clearly said, my body is not God, but my spirit is God. Show me that in the Bible.
No, because your criteria is wrong.
No. You made the claim.
No, wait.
Can I speak now? I'll let you speak.
No, but
I'm going to show you. I'm going to clarify something to you.
This is important.
No, I haven't finished.
No, this is important.
Jason.
No, excuse me.
I haven't finished.
For us.
No, but Jason, let me finish.
If you get this wrong, for us, it's like blasphemy.
No, but let me finish.
No, it's very, very serious. It's very serious.
You're not letting me finish, are you?
If you read John chapter 1, verse 15.
Yeah, Allah, because you know, let me finish. I'm telling you, look, you said that the body of Jesus is not God, the spirit is God, correct? Is that right? Is that correct?
No. Don't put words.
I'm asking you correctly if I'm wrong.
I quote you what the Bible says. Yeah.
Jesus, not Paul, not Mark. Jesus.
No, I don't listen to your criteria.
So I'm saying.
Well,
that's
Quran,
why I brought.
The Quran agrees with John
excuse
anyway.
Me, excuse me. Excuse me. That's why Bart Ehrman said. He said when you look to Jesus' teaching, it different than the disciples. No. Not disciples. That Mark and Matthew. Why? Because when you look to Mark and Matthew's teaching.
You don't put this on the camera now. You just said to us. You've been caught now. You said to us, I don't have Western scholars.
I'm just guessing.
No.
For my religion.
I have my Muslim scholars. And then, you try to criticize me with Western scholars.
Because you're Western.
You're scholars.
That's not hypocrisy, Jason.
I bet you change it.
There's no sincerity. Now change it. You said that. Anyway, to my viewers.
You said.
Jason.
You said. Yeah. You don't use Western scholars.
For my religion.
Yeah. But you use them against me.
You are Western, are you? Are you Eastern or Western?
And Bart Ehrman.
Are you Western? Is he a scholar? Anyway.
I'm reading the verse. You asked the question.
Yeah. But Jesus is saying that he's a God.
It says, verse 14, and the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory. What's the Word?
The Word, you mean Jesus made flesh?
What's the Word?
Jesus, you mean Jesus?
What's the Word?
I'm saying Jesus.
What's the Word?
Jesus.
And who's, no, what is the Word? What does the Word say there? In the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God.
So God became flesh.
What's the Greek word for was?
I don't know. So God became flesh.
Well, let me explain to you.
Are you gonna? He's gonna be. Are you finished,
let
Jason?
Let me explain. The Greek word there has the idea of like a seal wax. When you put a letter and you stamp it and it's a seal, yeah?
Yeah.
It's like a seal. It's like the exact same as God. In the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God.
Okay.
Can you find?
No, no, no.